Hello everyone, I am Shih-Shinh Huang from National Kaohsiung University of Science and Technology, Taiwan. The topic I want to talk about is RPN, short for Region Proposal Network. The objective of RPN is to generate possible object regions, coded object proposals. RPN was firstly proposed and used in the paper entitled as Faster RCNN in 2015. The outline of this lecture includes introduction about what object detection is, and the background of RPN, RPN architecture about the anchor for encoding object proposal, convolutional networks, and the contribution of RPN, RPN training about the training steps, and the rules for anchor selection, and the loss function defined for training RPN. The input of the object detection are an input image I and the set of object classes to be detected. For example, for this given image, we want to detect cat, dog, and duck. The output of the object detection are bounding box of the M detected objects and their class labels. Here shows the bounding box of four detected objects and their class labels respectively. In general, an object detector consists of two stages. In proposal generation stage, it captures the rectangular bounding box of all possible objects. In proposal classification stage, it assigns class labels to all bounding box and removes the background bounding box as well. As the paper published in 2014, the proposed RCNN has made a remarkable advance in object detection by using features from convolutional neural networks. It uses selective search for proposal generation. Then it computes CNN features of each proposal and classifies it by supporter vector machine. Here shows the processing flow of the RCNN. As mentioned, selective search is firstly used to generate object proposals. For the first proposal, we compute its CNN feature and then perform SVM to classify it as dog. For the next proposal, we do the same thing. After traversing all proposals, we got the detection result. However, RCNN is slow because it performs convolutional forward paths for each proposal. To reduce computation complexity of RCNN, Faster RCNN was proposed in 2015 that shares convolutional feature map across proposals. In other words, the convolutional feature map of the input image is computed just once. Then, the feature maps for the first proposal, second proposal, to the last proposal are clipped from the convolutional feature map without recomputing. These clipped feature maps are normalized and stacked into a single feature map by the proposed ROI plugin. Finally, a classification network is used to assign class labels to all proposals. In this architecture, selective search becomes computational bottleneck. The main idea to further reduce computation complexity is to generate proposals based on convolutional feature map shared with classification stage. In place of selective search, a convolutional neural network coded RPN is proposed for proposal generation. RPN directly operates on convolutional feature map to achieve feature sharing with classification stage. Before to detail the convolution layers, we introduce the anchors used in RPN architecture. Anchors are reference box for encoding proposal. Let SYWH and SAYAWHA are the bounding box of a proposal and an anchor respectively. A proposal is thus parameterized as DSDY DWDH relative to an anchor, where DXDY is the displacement vector from anchor center SAYA to proposal center SY divided by anchor width and height respectively. DWDH is the scaling factors in width and height of the proposal with respect to the anchor. Next, we detail the way to generate proposals via anchors. We attach 9 anchors centered at each point of the convolutional feature map. 9 anchors result from 3 aspect ratios for detecting various object types, by 3 scales for dealing with scale variance. Then, we predict 1 proposal with respect to each anchor and use 6 parameters to describe a proposal. DXDYDWDH are box parameters as mentioned before, and POVJ, PVG denote the object and the background class probabilities of the proposal respectively. More specifically, 9 anchors attached to each point are variant in 3 different aspect ratios and 3 different sizes. Then, 9 proposals relative to the 9 anchors are predicted by given 9x4 dimensional relative box parameters and 9x2 dimensional class probabilities. After introducing the idea of anchors for proposal generation, we overview the RPN convolutional network. The convolutional feature map of the input image is firstly computed. This paper uses VGG16 for computing convolutional feature map, whose number of channels is 512. Then, RPN predicts 9 proposals relative to 9 anchors for first point, second point, until all points. It finally outputs box parameter and class probability maps with 36 and 18 channels respectively. By suppressing non-maxima proposals, the final object proposals are generated for further processing. Let's look into RPN architecture, which consists of 3 convolution layers. Intermediate layers convert the input convolutional feature map to the one specifically for proposal generation. Regression layer predicts the box parameters of all proposals. Classification layer predicts object and background probabilities of all proposals. The objective of intermediate layer is to extract feature map for proposal generation. The first step is to pad one pixel around the input convolutional feature map. Then, 512 convolution kernels with size 3x3x512 are used for convolution. Convolution by one kernel results in a W/H/1 feature map. Convolution by two kernels results in a W/H/2 feature map. Accordingly, the output of intermediate layer is a W/H/512 feature map. The regression layer performs convolution using 9x4 convolution kernels with a size 1x1x512. It converts the feature map to the bus parameter map with a size W/H/36. It has 36 values at each point, denoting the bus parameters of the 9 proposals, and totally has bus parameters of W/H/9 proposals. Similarly, the classification layer performs convolution using 9x2 convolution kernels with 1x1x512 to output class probabilities of all W/H/9 proposals. The main contribution of the RPN is to use the multi-scale anchors for detecting objects in multi-scales due to perspective phenomena. Image pyramid and filter pyramid are two basic approaches for addressing this issue. The image pyramid approach resizes images and compute feature maps at multi-scales called the image pyramid, and slide a fixed size detection window to detect objects. The filter pyramid approach slides detecting window of multi-scales on a feature map to detect objects. Although these two approaches can detect objects in multi-scales, they are time-consuming. Instead, RPN uses multiple-scale anchors, or coded anchor pyramid. The anchor attached to each point are with three scales. This makes RPN rely on the image of single scale. In addition, multi-scale anchors at the same point share the same feature. For example, the feature map at the red point are shared by 9 anchors at this point to predict 9 proposals. Sharing feature in this manner addresses scaling variance without extra cost. After introducing the RPN architecture, we talk about the steps to train RPN. The first step of RPN training is to select an image from training dataset. The next step is to assign a label to each anchor, followed by forming a mini batch consisting of 256 anchors. The final step is to minimize the defined loss function by SGD with this learning rate setting. As mentioned, an image is randomly selected from the training dataset. Anchors are then labeled and assembled to form the mini batch. At the same time, the image is as the input of RPN to predict proposals relative to the selected anchors. After that, the loss is computed and back propagated to update values of the convolution kernels. In the next section, we will detail the anchor labeling and the loss computation. Anchor labeling is to assign a class label to each anchor. For example, there are 5 anchors and 2 ground truth buses. After anchor labeling, each anchor will be assigned one of 3 labels, positive, border, or negative. The metric for measuring bus overlap is IOU, short for intersection over union. For a red bus A and green bus B, their IOU is defined as intersection region divided by union region. For these 5 anchors, we firstly compute their IOU with respect to the ground truth buses. The anchors satisfying one of the 2 rules are labeled as positive. The first rule is that it has the highest IOU with a ground truth bus. In this example, these 2 anchors satisfy this rule and are labeled as positive. The second rule is that it has IOU greater or equal than 0.7 with any ground truth bus. This anchor means this rule and is also labeled as positive. If the anchor has IOU less than 0.3 for all ground truth buses, it is labeled as negative. In this example, this anchor is labeled as negative. The remaining anchors are labeled as border, as this one in this example. Let D be the set of selected anchors. For explanation purpose, we only select two anchors in this example. D hat I is the bus parameters of the ground truth bus associated with ice anchor. In this example, D hat 1 is the bus parameters of the anchor 1 and can be computed as this equation defined before. Similarly, for the anchor 2, P hat I is the class probabilities of the ice anchor. For positive anchor, we set its P hat OVJ equal to 1.0 and P hat VG equal to 0.0, but vice versa for negative anchor. Let DIPI be the proposal parameters predicted by RPN via anchors. Here is the example of proposal parameters predicted by RPN via these two anchors. Loss function L is to evaluate fitness of DIPI to D hat I P hat I and is defined as the sum of regression term and the classification term. The regression term introduces P hat OVJ to make it only depend on positive anchors. The function LIEG evaluates the difference between DI and D hat I via smooth L1 function. It is defined as the sum of difference respectively in S, Y, W, and I via L1 function. In this example, only anchor 1 is considered for evaluation, and the regression loss can be expressed as this equation. After simple computation, it can be further expressed as this equation. Here gives the definition of L1 function and its graphical representation. Accordingly, this equation leads to the regression loss. For classification loss, it is the sum of L sub C LS function over all anchors. This equation is the definition of L sub C LS function, which is the log loss function. For our example with two anchors, classification loss can be expressed as this equation. After substitution, we got the classification loss. In this lecture, we introduce a CNN-coded RPN for object proposal generation. This significantly reduces computation complexity in object detection by sharing feature with classification stage. Instead of using image or filter pyramid, this paper introduces the anchor pyramid for dealing with scaling variance. Thanks for your listening and have a nice day.